that even Sarah Huckabee Sanders acknowledges in her work, she acknowledges the bars in the Hatch Act, correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, so we have many members of the president's own administration who honor the law and respect the law. The violations here, to the extent and the repetitiveness to which they are being committed, is unique to Ms. Conway, correct?
Yes.
Okay, and with that, I would like to show you all a video that highlights many of the violations that the Office of Special Counsel detailed in its report.
Anything times zero equals zero. Simple multiplication. So 50 Democrats can run, 20 Democrats, 19 are now running, but if your message is zero, it's a big zero. There's no strategy, I see. You've got Beto O'Rourke and you've got Cory Booker promising that they would nominate a woman to be the VP. Do they not think the women running are good enough to be president? Stop the nonsense, everybody, about we are for all women. We are pro-women. We are for independent thinkers. You have Elizabeth Warren running for president. She tried to appropriate somebody else's ethnicity. She lied about that. They've got a bunch of, I like to say, I don't see any presidential timber yet, just presidential wood chips.
Yeah, Kelly.
And the women are complaining too. You guys see women on TV complaining about the female candidates aren't covered the same. That's just hogwash. They just have terrible ideas. Nobody, but you can change the A to an O and get Oh My instead of Amy there, because I don't think that was a very impressive rollout. Kirsten Gillibrand this weekend in her 50s apparently was the first time she's ever eaten fried chicken, and she waited for the cameras to roll. I mean, this is just silly stuff. The only difference between Bernie Sanders and Donald Trump is Bernie Sanders' ideas are terrible for America, and Donald Trump was a much better candidate, had connective tissue with the people. I think Biden's timing actually benefits him, because the Democrats seem really desperate to find an alternative to Bernie Sanders.
So, Mr. Kerner, I want to walk through some of the specific Hatch Act violations that OSC found that Kellyanne Conway committed. On November 20th, she gave an interview with Fox and Friends in which she called the Democratic Senate candidate Doug Jones a, quote, doctrinaire liberal. This was a Hatch Act violation, correct?
That was in our first report, correct?
And on December 6, 2017, Ms. Conway appeared in her official capacity on CNN and discussed why voters should support Republican Senate candidate Roy Moore and why they should not support Democratic candidate Doug Jones. OSC then sent President Trump a report detailing these violations, but you did not recommend a specific form of discipline. You left that up to the president, correct?
Correct.
The president appears to have done nothing about this, and Ms. Conway continued to violate the law. OSC found that between October 31st and November 6th, Ms. Conway posted at least 15 messages that violated the Hatch Act to her Twitter account. Are you aware of any other senior aide to a president who has systematically violated the Hatch Act to this extent by attacking the potential opponents of the president?
I am not aware.
And I think this right here gets at the core of what we're talking about today, is that this is not even partisan, because members of Trump's own administration do not violate the law, this law, to the extent that she does. She is being subject to these reports because she is unique in her flagrant and violation and disrespect for the law. And frankly, when she doesn't show up to her own congressional hearing today, she's not just disrespecting Democrats. I don't mind. That's something that she does on TV every day. She disrespects the entire body. She disrespects every Republican member of this body and disrespects the power that each and every single one of us has. And moreover, I think that this taps into a deeper narrative and a deeper pattern of what is happening out of this administration, where they believe that the rule of law only belongs and applies to some people and not others. Right here and now, we're about 20 years away from the Central Park Five, where the president put out a full-page ad demanding the death penalty for five black and brown boys. Boys, they were not yet 18 years old, demanding the death penalty for something they were accused of and innocent of. And here we have just documented evidence of multiple times of violation of the same law, and he won't even issue a slap on the wrist. This is a pattern about some people being subject to the rule of law and others not. And when that happens, there is no rule of law at all. at all. And that's why it's important that we make sure that everyone is held accountable, because whether it's a billionaire, whether it's an administration official, or whether it's a postal worker or a kid on the street, we all must be held accountable to the same extent by the rule of law. Thank you very much. Thank